In today's video, I want to talk about finding a project for yourself to work on if you're looking to practice and hone your newly found programming skills. Welcome back. My name is Tim Buchalka, and this is another programming tip of the day. A question I get very often from students is, can you provide me with some more practice assignments, or how do I find a project to work on? Now, there's a lot of ways that you can actually do that. One of the ways you can start with, first one, is to find a small need for an application, a program, and try and write that for yourself. Don't try and figure out, you know, how to sell it or see if there's an audience who need it. Come up with a very simple program to solve a particular problem. I've got a really weird story for you, but back when I was starting out programming, I actually wrote, one of my first programs I wrote was a very simple game. And believe it or not, I wrote it for my mother, because I had this first computer, a Micro B, it had 16K of RAM. This is back in the 1980s. And I wanted to write a very simple game and show my parents, show my mother. So I wrote a simple game, which was called a reaction timer. So I had to try and figure out how to do that. And what I decided to do was time the difference between when it said go to when I pressed the space bar, and come up with basically a reaction to how long it took for that game, and had a high score ladder. So a really, really, really simple game, very, very primitive. But that was great fun, and that was a project, because I had to work through the system. I had to figure out things like how to display something on the screen. I had to figure out how to calculate time from when the program said go, and when the space bar was pressed. And I had to show how to calculate that and print out the results on the screen. So that very simple, simple game was a great way to learn some basic programming skills. And again, it was one of the first things that I learned to program. So that's one example. Another example that I can give you of a more complex program was back in 2005. I joined a new ISP, internet service provider, and at the time they didn't have a usage meter. So in other words, there's no way to track how many gigabytes, or in that case it was more tracking megabytes, but basically how much usage for a particular month. And that's more of an issue in countries like Australia, where there's a premium price on data usage. So you basically need to track your usage to make sure that your bill's not too high. Anyway, so the company didn't have the facility to, didn't offer that as a program. So I thought, okay, I'm gonna write a program to do that. So I wrote a program to actually do just that, to have a very simple calculation, and it was sitting there in the background and monitoring how much you were using and saving that into a very primitive text file, a really primitive form of a database. So the point was, again, that I figured out a need for a program, and actually wrote that and solved that. That's way back in 2005 that I worked on that. And I ended up actually making that program a lot more complex and working with the internet service provider. And they actually gave me a way to pull the stats from their server, because they were actually recording the stats internally. They just weren't presenting them to the users of their service. So that was an app, and I'm gonna put a link in the resources for this video, or in the description for this video. If you're interested, you can go and check out the original code, but it's all the way back from 2005. I released it as open source, and that was another good way of doing it. And that really leads me into the second point, actually, of contributing to an open source project. One of the great ways that you can practice your skills is to find an open source project. Now, an open source project, if you're not aware of it, is basically a program that someone has put out there to solve a particular need or solve a particular problem, and it's released for free. And depending on the license, there's usually no great restrictions. You're able to take that code and adapt it or contribute it to the project. So I've contributed to a lot of projects over the last 20 plus years now. A great site you can go to is github.com. Now, GitHub has been recently purchased by Microsoft, but don't let that be a negative thing, because I know there's some people out there who, for whatever reason, don't like Microsoft. Great site, GitHub, and there's thousands of projects in virtually any programming language you can think of that need contributions. Now, that when you're contributing to an open source project, that doesn't mean you need to be an expert programmer. There's lots of different ways you can contribute. One of the early ways that I contributed to a project was with the documentation. So I was more a user of a particular program, and I decided to hone the documentation and to make the documentation easier to show people how to install the application and to get the most out of it. So you might want to start there. It can be simple as finding bugs. So you might have decide to take that code base, the program from GitHub or any other open source repository, source code repository, and you might find a bug. You might sort of run the program and find that it doesn't work on your system. You know, perhaps it's a particular version of Windows or whatever it is, a particular scenario, and it doesn't work. So you might firstly report that it's a bug, because most of these projects have got the mechanisms for you to report a bug. But secondly, you might then decide, okay, I'm going to have a go at fixing it. And this can be really, really good practice for you to hone your skills, because you're taking a real application that someone's developed and you're trying to figure out the flow of the program and you're trying to debug it. You're trying to find the bug and fix it. And what you can do is you can then contribute that change, that fix, back to the people who wrote it, back to through to the repository. And that can flow in as a future version of that program. And that can be a good feeling, because you can eventually get your name up in credits, so to speak, because you've actually contributed to the project. So I wouldn't necessarily say you should contribute purely to get your name up in lights, but I know that can be a good thing when you're going for a job to say you've contributed to these projects. But if you go there and do that, you'll find that the real world skills that you'll learn by working with someone else's code and interacting with people can be really set you up and help you in your journey to become a good programmer. So I would suggest either of those methods. Firstly, find a particular problem. It can be a simple problem or a complex problem, and try and solve that by writing a computer program, or write as much of it as you can. Secondly, find an open source project and see if you can contribute to that. Both of those ways will definitely help you become a better programmer. Alrighty, so I hope that helped. If you've got any questions, feel free to leave a comment and I'll get back to you. If you're ready to look at the next tip, click on up here and you can check that out. If you're interested in coding specific programming videos, click on the link in the bottom left-hand corner. Consider subscribing by clicking on the link up here, and I'll see you soon.